Blackstone Audio presents Blackman's Coffin by Mark Castrique. In memory of Doug Marlett, who encouraged me to march to my own drummer while he ran to his own symphony. Chapter 1. I felt a hand on my shoulder, shaking me awake.
Now you can pass as a local. They've all got one leg shorter than the other. Comes from being raised on the side of a mountain.
The woman sitting beside my hospital bed laughed at her own joke and then offered me a paper bag.
Who the hell are you?
I pushed the control to incline the bed to where I could see her eye to eye. I didn't need someone waking me up and rubbing my nose in my predicament. She tossed the bag onto my chest.
Tikima Robertson, Marine Corps, retired. Never got over it, so now I come to the VA hospital to harass the leathernecks who feel sorry for themselves.
She gave a salute. The dark metal hook at the end of her forearm brushed her arched eyebrow.
What I figure is if the Marines had had a few more good women, we'd have been out of Iraq 3 years ago.
Then let me be the first to encourage you to re-up.
I glanced down at the bag and saw a hardback copy of Elmore Leonard's Up in Honey's Room. I'm a Leonard fan, and the gift cooled my anger a few degrees.
I would have re-enlisted, but when I type, I tear up the computer keyboard.
She waved the prosthetic hook in front of me.
So the Corps didn't want me back in public disinformation.
I snapped off the sheet and uncovered my maimed left leg. She looked where the stump ended, just below the knee.
Not so bad, but you can't use one of these back scratchers. You'll snag the carpet every time you walk.
I smiled. You're full of black humor, aren't you?
That's what a black woman's for. Keep a black man from taking himself too seriously, even if he's white like you, Chief Warrant Officer Sam Blackman.
I raised my hands in mock surrender.
I give up. What do you want?
Give up? Well, if I didn't already know it, you just proved you're an army and a glorified MP, not even a real soldier.
My temper flared. I lifted the book and shoved it toward her. No thanks. I don't want your gift or your insults. And we all turned into MPs over there. One goddamn police force trying to separate people who only hate us a little more than they hate each other. Tikima flinched and looked away. I held the book over the edge of the bed, waiting for her to take it. She sighed and turned to me.
Sorry, that was uncalled for. Sometimes I try too hard to make a connection.
She stood.
But keep the book. Ain't Mr. Leonard's fault I got no tact.
Her apology sounded straight from the heart.
Wait a minute, you're not getting off so easy.
I nodded to the chair.
No woman walks out on Sam Blackman.
She hesitated a moment, and then the twinkle returned to her eyes.
Is that an order?
Yes, from a glorified MP. Do I have to handcuff you?
Well, it helps to have hands.
She scooted the chair nearer and sat. I gave her a closer look. Tikima had dark, smooth skin and a shapely figure that her khaki pantsuit couldn't hide. She wore her curly black hair cropped close to her head. Her ringless left hand rested in her lap as a cradle for the hook. I have difficulty estimating a woman's age, but I guessed she was in her mid-30s, a couple of years older than me. She cleared her throat as if to start our conversation anew.
So, have you found a guy in here with only a left foot so you can go in on shoes together?
No, but I left a request back in Amputee Alley at Walter Reed to be on the lookout for a prospect.
Came through there myself 3 years ago. They tried to give me one of those new fake arms they claim looks real. Black plastic supposed to match my skin. My skin's no more black than yours is white. I look like I'd stolen the arm off Darth Vader. I said, forget this, give me something that works.
Tikima lifted her arm. The hook was actually a curved vise with one side longer than the other.
I shrugged my shoulder and the clamp closes.
The tips met with an audible click.
Now I mail Amputee Alley all my right-handed gloves.
I decided we'd best get the war stories out of the way. If Tikima Robertson had been sent by some army shrink to have me open up, then we could check that off the to-do list.
How'd you lose the hand?
Shrapnel.
In Iraq? I thought Marine women were kept out of combat.
Oh, did I miss the memo about where the front line was?
She shook her head.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.